Welcome back to the Wisdom Lifestyle Money Show. I'm your host, Scott Dillingham, and I've got a special guest with us today, Phil Bould.
Hi, Scott. How are you doing?
Awesome. How are you doing, Phil?
Doing great. Busy, but doing great.
That's awesome. Yeah, same here. I wanted to have you on. Well, actually, first I want to hear your story, but the theme of today's topic is what's going on in the market. Should you buy? Should you hold off? And just some things that are going around, you know, in the neighborhood and what's going on. So why don't you start with telling a little bit of, you know, about you and...
Well, I work for Team Goran, Remax Care. I've been in the business for over 17 years. I've gone through the good times, bad times in the market. I think I'm actually kind of excited about the market that's coming up. A lot of agents are afraid, but I'm engaged in it. I've worked it before where it was a buyer's market. It went to a balanced market, went to a seller's market really, really fast. And now it's starting to go back to a more balanced market, which is nice. You don't have the multiple offers. You're not driving around showing places. And then you're putting an offer in against 20 other offers. And only one's going to get the home. And you get a lot of disappointed people because they didn't get it and someone else did. So I'm really looking forward to this market. The people have said I should wait to buy a house because we think the houses are going to go down.
Yeah.
I don't really see that happening. The interest rates have affected the value of the houses, but you also have a buying power. So the higher it goes up, you might have had, say, a 800,000 approval, and it goes up 1%. Now your buying power is decreased by 10%. So now you're looking at a 720 approval now. So it sort of balances out. So it doesn't matter if you wait, then you're still going to be having the same monthly payments for the same kind of house. Yeah. So I would buy now. There's a lot of good things coming to Windsor. Windsor's got so many investments in it, and we have Amazon, we have the battery plant. Crisis is going to a third shift again, which is great to hear. The hospital's being built. All these workers are coming, the bridge. So all these workers are coming too, and they have to have places to stay. So a lot of people are going to be buying up these places, which will be increasing the value of all homes. And once those jobs are in place, we're going to have 15,000 to 20,000 new jobs in Windsor.
Yeah.
That's really going to affect our housing prices in Windsor. So I would jump on now instead of waiting before you wait too long and then you realize that the prices have gone up and you've got a high interest rate too on top of it. So
Yeah. If
you can wait maybe a month or two, it might not be so bad, but I would get on it while you can, while the prices are still decent. We're still number three, I think, in the nation of Canada of affordable homes.
Yeah, I saw that article. Actually, I'm going to go back to something you said in the beginning. You said that you're looking forward to this market, but a lot of people, a lot of agents are scared of this market. Why are they scared?
I don't know. I think that they're taking, a lot of agents are taking a step back. Okay. They don't know how to handle it. At Team Goran, we talk about this kind of stuff every morning. We have a Zoom meeting every morning with the whole team and Goran. And we're ready for it. We're ready for this market. We've planned for this market. We know how to deal with this market. Goran is a great leader. He's an amazing leader, and he's got us ready for whatever situation comes up. If it's a balanced market, buyer market, seller market, we are ready.
That's
and
awesome.
We're good to go.
Cool. No, that's awesome. Now, for anybody listening to this, right, because this show is all over Canada, we currently live and reside in southwestern Ontario in a town called Windsor. So some of the things that Phil's speaking about is locally to Windsor. And I want to touch on some of them. So we're kind of talking about the battery plant before the show started. Could you tell us a little bit about that? And we'll dive into the investments that are happening in the region and why we believe that those investments will really help foster our real estate growth that we're
Believe the battery plant is going to produce about 5,000 jobs.
Okay.
But there's also all these spin-offs of those jobs. The tool and die and all those other plants and other businesses are related to it. Plus all the stores, people have more money to spend, so all the stores are going to be busier too. So there's a lot of money coming to Windsor, a lot of jobs, which will spin off to a lot of other jobs on top of it too. So
in the battery plant is for cars, right? They're car
batteries. Yeah, car batteries.
Yeah. Now, I heard as well that some of the batteries, or most of them, are going to be for exporting.
Yeah, but Chrysler's, they are making a battery-powered car here in Windsor, too, and that's why we're having a third shift now. We have the battery plant here, so it makes sense for Chrysler's to have a battery-powered car and produce it here so they don't have to travel so far with the batteries.
And batteries are heavy, right? So transporting them has a cost, right? So they're saving that. That's cool. So
basically, here from Chatham is going to start doing really well. Chatham, I believe there's something in Chatham or Tilbury too as well that where they're going to be getting batteries as well too.
Yeah, I heard something about that. I don't know too much about that, so I don't want to touch on it here and say the wrong thing. But I did hear about that. So let's talk about the bridge. So somebody who's not aware, right? So we already have a bridge here in Windsor, and we have a tunnel that goes from Windsor to Detroit as well. So we have two border crossings. Can you talk about the?
Oh, we're gonna have a third one. I forget the cost of it. I know it's in the billions.
Yes.
And 2025, it should be hopefully done. If there's no more delays or red tape that they have to go through, but it looks like everything's in the clear right now. So that's going to be providing a lot of other jobs to build in the next few years. Also, the traffic flow will be even better here in Windsor, too, from the border, from Detroit to Windsor.
Yeah.
So we're already the busiest border crossing in Canada with our Ambassador Bridge right now. So once we get this other bridge, it's going to be easier to go through. A lot of trucks will be going through that one, I would imagine, because it's easier to access the 401 and also the highways in the States. And a lot of cars will be traveling back and forth on the regular bridge, the Ambassador Bridge.
And the other thing too, and I don't know if you're seeing this, you probably are because you help people to obviously buy and sell houses, but on the mortgage side of things, I'm getting clients that are applying and they're being transferred here from GTA, you know, anywhere really, a lot from GTA though, to Windsor because their company is opening up here because the trade between the US and Canada is going to be so much better, faster, more efficient with the third border crossing. So they're actually opening up facilities here. Are you seeing that from your buyers?
Yeah, we're getting a lot of buyers from the Toronto area. We always have, but we get a lot of calls from the Toronto people, the wanting to move to the Windsor area because it's just affordable. They can sell their house for $2 million and get the same kind of house over here for, say, $700,000. And they have, you know, $1.3 million in the bank that they have to enjoy their retirement.
Yeah.
So, or their early retirement too. So, and a lot of investors too will buy properties to rent in Windsor because the rent's pretty high here. Not as high as Toronto, but the investment of the property is a lot lower. So yeah. it makes sense for them to buy here and rent and make more of a profit than Toronto.
Yeah, no, I agree. So we've got, just to kind of wrap it all together, we've got major battery plant, lots of jobs, major bridge, lots of jobs, companies opening here. Right? So that means there's demand.
Yeah, and huge demand.
We're missing out on one thing that Windsor lagged in a lot of cities is houses, like places to live in condos and stuff, right? Where you go to Toronto, you see cranes everywhere.
Yeah.
I know some of their projects are stopping or slowing down, but in Windsor, the demand is there. Now we have projects that are being built, so more units will be available soon, but there's still so much demand because of that. So it's really, really cool. From that demand standpoint, do you see our market crashing? Can you see that happening?
No, not with the investments. It's just, if we didn't have these investments coming, if we didn't have the battery plant, Amazon, the built new hospital, the bridge being built, and whatever else is coming our way, the third line of the Chrysler's, I would be worried about Windsor and the future of Windsor. But so many big investments. The government of Ontario invested, I think it was $14 billion for Ontario. I believe we got $9 billion of it in investment. So a lot of times Windsor is the forgotten city, but finally they've noticed us and put us back on the map. And
awesome.
Windsor's going to be good. We might have a little bit of recession for about a year, they're saying, but after that year, we're going to be blossoming and be a strong city.
Yep. No, that's awesome. Now, one thing that I want to talk about, and you can confirm this, because right, you're seeing the sales prices. You know, we see the ones that we're doing the lending for, but you probably see more of what's going on. But so a lot of people are saying, oh, the market's crashing, don't buy now. But if you look at the data, and correct me if I'm wrong, but just from the data that I looked at recently, the sales prices of houses are higher today than they were in January. So even though they're cooling, I'm seeing numbers that are showing that they're still selling for more than what they did in January. Is that right?
Yeah, they haven't, they maybe in the last month or two, with the interest rates going up, they might have dipped a little bit, but from January to, say, May, it was a very good increase of prices of houses.
Yeah.
There's a little bit of a dip right now. It's not going to stay very long. I don't think it's going to go much longer or any more of a dip. They are still having multiple offers on properties, so there is still a demand on houses. So if you're looking to sell, or you're afraid you've lost out because you didn't sell when it was hot, it's still a pretty hot market, and you're still getting multiple offers and still people bidding over the house price. If the house is priced already too high, obviously it might not sell right away and you won't be getting the multiple offers. But if it's priced at a good marketable price, you'll get those multiple offers and you'll get a lot more than you expected for your house.
Yeah. And I don't know about you, but I actually think this is a more fair market to buy in, because prior, like I had clients that they knew the house was not worth what they're paying, but they're willing to pay way over just to get something.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Another thing too, related to that too, is now I'm starting to see more home inspection conditions. So I didn't like it when we had a market where people were just doing cash offers, bidding as high as they possibly could, and no home inspections. And then they buy the house and they move in and they find out they have a lot of problems. So it's nice to see that it's going back to where you can put the home inspection clause in there and you can still get an accepted offer with it.
Yeah, you're right. So it gives them that protection that they didn't have during the craziness. And it's not like it's crashed like we've went over here. There's a lot of strong fundamentals to keep the market strong. But it's just that, like you said, there's not the crazy bidding wars, and you can get a price at a good deal. And if you're selling, you're still selling for higher, potentially, than what it was in January, which is still an increase.
Oh, yeah, so you're still, you'll still do well. Still do well.
Yeah.
But I'm just really happy to see the home inspections, because I've been doing it for over 17 years. I've gone through a lot of home inspections. I see what they do, but I'm not a home inspector. So I'll go through a house, and fortunately the houses I sold didn't have those issues. But there are a lot of stories I've been hearing from other agents less experienced that did come across a problem because they didn't have a home inspection and there was issues. So it's nice to see those clauses come back and protect the buyers.
I remember there was a client that we had. He bought a home. This was in the summertime. He went with a different lender first. And it had nothing to do with the lender, but they discovered right before closing that the foundation was almost giving way on the home.
Oh, geez.
And so the lender's like, we're not doing this. So the client ended up backing away from the property, and he ended up going with us, and we helped him get a new one. But yeah, like that happens, right? And he had to go in cash because there was so much competition. So I think it all worked out because the seller did not disclose the foundation issue. So I think he was off the hook. But you're right. This gives buyers protection, which is great. And it gives sellers still a good amount that they can sell their home for, because it's, again, it's higher than.
Yeah. Yeah. It was just before, it was such a seller's market that people had to avoid any conditions and make their offer as pretty as possible for the seller. And we've even done things where we put pictures of the sellers. If it's a nice family, we put the picture of the family in there and try to do whatever it takes to, so we still do that too, do whatever it takes will help my buyer. But we started doing that more too, and maybe a nice letter along with it too. And
absolutely. So question for you then. So let's say I want to sell my home, but I'm a little concerned because I think I won't get as much as I would have if I sold it a couple months ago. Do you have some tips or strategies that you would let your client know or advise so they can still sell it for maximum dollar in today's market?
Well, the first thing I would say is pick a good brokerage. With our brokerage, we market and spend lots of money on advertising to make sure that you do get top dollar for your house. We'll go through the house. When I'm about to list the house, I'll go through it, see if there's a little simple, cheaper things you can do just to touch it up and make it look ready for showings. Less clutter, fresh paint, maybe sealing the windows better, or the bathtubs, put new sealer on it so it looks fresh and new. Just make it look presentable for listing. I've seen people that want to sell their house and their house is a total disaster.
Yeah.
And they think they're ready for taking pictures and they're far from it. So just have your house ready. Pick a good brokerage that's going to be marketing and advertising your property. Not somebody that's going to just put a sign on your front lawn and put on the MLS and that's as far as they go. We have a marketing company, our marketing people in our office, or in-house marketing people, and that's their job. I sell real estate. I'm not a marketing person. but these people are. And so we have a marketing team, we have a photography team, we have a lot of things set up to make sure we are get your house noticed. And we also have a guy in Texas to make sure that all our searches are on top of the search lists too. Nice. So we invest a lot of money to make top dollar for our sellers.
No, that's awesome. Now, is this true? If you bake cookies, someone's going to buy your house for a higher price. Is that true? I've heard that.
Well, brownies. Everybody likes cookies, especially chocolate chip is my yeah. weakness. You walk into a house, you smell the nice aroma of cookies. It's definitely going to make it more noticeable and pleasant. So okay. Anyone likes, you know, the smell of fresh baked goods.
So maybe you should bake some cookies.
Yes, I'll have to get some tips from my wife to find out how to bake cookies. Okay. I'll get some bigger sales.
That's awesome. No, that's awesome.
It does help. It any kind of smell, because you have all your senses. You have your sight where you see the house, and you have your smell.
Yeah.
A lot of times I'll walk into a house, it smells good. Sometimes it smells musty. So it's that's why I had a lot of people that will trust me enough to have me go through a house because they live out of town. So I'll go through, like on a Zoom meeting with them through the house, but and they're fine with that. But then I'll use my other senses to make sure that the house is good. If I do smell anything bad in the house, I'll let them know. Okay. If it smells nice, then you'll go in the basement, you'll see if there's musty stuff too. But before you even walk in the house, a lot of times you can smell musty.
And it's actually, I love the advice that you're giving here, because on the properties that are following what you're saying, there's so much demand. Actually, you have a story about Pelee Island in a property. So why don't you touch on that? But pretty much high level, if you follow what Phil's saying here and you're listing your house, there will be demand and there can be multiple offers. And Phil, let's talk about
my Pelee Island story.
Yes.
All right. Well, I met a couple. I had new clients coming from Waterloo. And I've never been to Pelee Island before. And didn't know what to expect with these people. You're on a boat for an hour and a half going there, a ferry ride that will take your car. And then you come back an hour and a half with the ferry again. And also I'm gonna be on this island for about 4 hours with these people too. So I didn't know what to expect. First time I met them. So I did meet them on the boat, and it was a husband and wife and their two kids. One of the nicest families I've ever come across. Super, super nice people. Had a nice day. It was a Sunday, so I had a nice day on Pelee Island with their family. And I showed them three houses, and they liked all three, but they had one in particular that they liked. There was one house that we didn't look at because it didn't have pictures on the inside. So we thought, if it doesn't have pictures, it probably isn't any good. And then the next day, they posted pictures on the inside, and it looked really, really nice. So they asked me, they called me up, said, okay, we're in Waterloo, but do you mind going on Skype, and we'll go through the house. So can you go back to Pelee Island? I was like, yeah, sure, no problem. A little bit of a problem, though. I tried to book the ferry and get my car on there, and the ferry was totally booked for my car. I can get on myself, but I couldn't get my car on. So I threw my mountain bike in the back of my car and went to Leamington to catch the ferry. I rode my bike an hour and a half on Pelee Island to the house. They loved the house. It was actually a really, really nice house, and that's the one they actually put an offer on. So we have a conditional offer, back to the condition, doing the conditions again.
Yeah.
And so we have this house on a conditional offer, and then I rode back to the ferry against the wind because it was a little bit of a windy day. So it was about an hour and 20 minutes going back. But that's the kind of things I'll do. You get obstacles, and you just have to overcome these obstacles you have. Yeah. So I had an obstacle of getting my car on there, so I took my bike and went for a nice bike ride on Pelee Island for an hour one way and an hour 20 minutes the other way against the wind.
No, that's funny. But it goes to show you, though, but your buyers almost left that property. They almost didn't buy it, right?
Right.
But because the pictures came through and it was nice and they probably advertised it correct, so... But
And they still haven't seen the house live, like in person. They're going by what I saw, going on Skype on the phone, so I could show them around, but they actually weren't in there. So I used my other senses to help them out with the smell and that, because they don't have those senses because they're on the phone. So, we went around, and that's the one they didn't see in person. That's the one they actually trusted me enough, and we really bonded. And you know, they didn't consider me their agent. They considered me a family member after that.
Yeah. Yeah, no, that's awesome. And so, I don't know, I love the fact that you went above and beyond, but it also does go to show you the demand, right?
So yeah.
They're in Waterloo buying a home sight unseen. So there's still a huge demand for homes. So I think anybody, and this is my opinion, of course, but anybody who is listing a home to sell or wants to buy, I honestly wouldn't hesitate to wait.
No, you wait, you're going to miss a boat again. Like a lot of people probably miss a boat when they're waiting to see if they should sell their house because they thought the house was going to go up more and more and more, and then it just sort of stabilized. So sell your house. It's a good time. Buying a house is a good time. I was trying to tell all my buyers to get locked into a mortgage rate before the interest rates went up. Yeah. And so before that happened, I got a lot of people locked in, but there's a lot of people that say, well, I'll wait a little bit. And now they're paying a higher interest rate. Right. And they're calling me and saying, you know, we should listen to you. And
And I remember too, like, so I've done mortgages for 10 years. And when I first started, a lot of the business I was getting was from GTA, just people I knew and just how it all worked out. I lived still here in Windsor, but I remember every single year people are like, oh, the market in GTA is going to crash, the housing values are going to crash, and every year they thought that. So you get those oddball ones that don't buy, but then everybody else does buy. So the people that bought 2-3 years ago are still so thankful because of their values. So I think, like, a lot of people let fear run their decisions, but I don't think that that's a smart move, because when you look at Toronto and everybody thinking it's going to crash every year, it still hasn't even when what it's going through, it's cooling, but it's not.
Toronto took a little bit of a hit. Not even close to what Windsor is. Windsor's still doing strong. But Toronto, they really did take a bit of a beating in the last few months.
Okay.
That's why we have, you know, even more people from the Toronto area looking over here to invest.
Okay.
Also, some people are looking at, now that the prices have gone down a little bit in Toronto, they also want to invest maybe in the Toronto area as well. So, Windsor's strong. Toronto, it will come back.
But my thought was, like, you can't hesitate. Like, you can't let that, right? Yeah. So for 10 years, it's went up and up and up.
Yeah,
so if somebody bought a home 10 years ago till now, they'd have at least $1 million, at least in equity, right? Yeah. Just from...
My brother lives in Toronto. He's a school teacher, high school teacher in Toronto, and he never bought in Toronto, and he wishes he did.
Yeah.
He's been there for about 30 years now, and if he would have bought a house back then, he would have been paying about $200,000 and sold it for $2 million today.
Yeah. So that's the point of what I'm trying to make is you can't wait. It doesn't matter if the market is Toronto, Vancouver, Windsor, right? If you have a home that you need to move into or a home that you need to sell, I do think waiting is a mistake. And that's what we wanted to chat about today, is there's so many strong fundamentals in our area that it does make sense to move forward and not listen to the doom and gloom of the news, because mostly that is what it is. Like, I did a bunch of different marketing courses, and they always talk about the news, and they say in the news, they sell fear.
Yes,
they do. That's what 100%. They have to sell for every topic, whether it's a fire, you know, car accident. It's all like the worst stuff because they want to sell newspapers and get people to watch it.
That's how they capture their audience.
Yeah.
It's unfortunate because a lot of good news would be nice to hear too.
Yes, but that's why you're only hearing the bad. Oh, the market's this, it's that, and it's really not that bad.
No, as I said before, there's a lot of good things coming to Windsor. We're going to be strong, and we might be a little bit of a recession because of the inflation and all that out of our control, but with the investments coming into Windsor, a lot of good things. It's going to be stronger than it's ever been. So if you wait, and the prices are going to just jump, and you're going to be scratching your head, why didn't I listen to Phil and start buying right now?
No, for sure. So before we wrap up for the day, is there any other tips maybe for buyers or anything else or any other messages that you'd like to throw out
there? Tips for buyers, again, pick the right brokerage, pick the right agent. Make sure that they're going to call you. I get all the people, sometimes I get buyers who will say, oh, you answered the phone. Because they called other brokerages and they didn't answer the phone. So when they've called me the first time and I answer my phone, they're actually a little bit surprised because I actually answer my phone when someone calls. And if I am at a meeting or something like that, or showing a property, I'll call you within about half an hour or so, or next in between houses. I'll always get back to you. Where a lot of agents are hard to get. I actually called this one Toronto agent one time because he was looking at one of my properties. I tried to call him. And on his voicemail, it said, I don't listen to my voicemail, and the best way to get a hold of me is through a text. Wow. So, and there's other ones that don't even have their voicemail even set up, so you can't even leave them a message. So there's a lot of agents like that, too. It just boggles my mind. But, and then for sellers, the market was, you'd list your house, you'd sell it in a week. The market's taking a little bit longer sometimes to sell a house. Sometimes it will sell in a week. Sometimes it might be a month. But just be patient. Have communication with your agent. Make sure your agent's communicating with you, because a lot of agents don't communicate properly, and they don't. They'll put the sign up and they'll say, I'll call you in a week, and that's about it. We try to call at least 3 times a week just to give you an update. If it's good news, bad news, just giving an update, just so you're in the loop and know. So, you know, they might be upset that there's might be no action in their house, but at least we've called and they're happy about that. Or, you know, we call them and said, there's a lot of action in your house, and, yeah, and we expect to get it sold this week.
Awesome. So somebody's listening to this and they resonated with your message and they want to give you a call. Or reach out to you one way or another. What's the best way for somebody to contact you?
Best way to call me. You can text me, but I like communication. I'm old school, and communicating through a text is hard. Yeah. But talking either to the phone or even come to my office, or I'll come to your house and talk to you in person, is the best way.
Perfect. And what is your phone number?
My phone number is 519-996-5501.
That's perfect. Well, awesome. I'm so glad you came on the show today, Phil. Thank you so much.
And hopefully I get some calls from some happy sellers or eager sellers and buyers, and I'll take good care of you, like always.
All right. Hopefully.
Also, another thing we have, too, is Google reviews. When you buy something, you always like to look at your reviews.
Yep.
Feel free to go on the Team Goran website and look at my reviews. My name is Phil Bould. And I've got all 5-star reviews and really, really nice things from my buyers and sellers. I've said things about me in the past. So, awesome. Yeah, feel free. That's another thing, too. When you're looking for an agent or brokerage, look at their Google reviews.
That's huge.
Agreed, yeah.
We have a 5-star. We have the highest Google reviews in Windsor, and all 5 stars. We're a 5-star brokerage.
No, good work. That's awesome, Phil. So thanks so much for tuning in, and I look forward to chatting with you guys next time.